morning announcements with Carden. Good morning, Carden.
Good morning, Zephania. We have the following announcements today. Our first announcement is, this morning, students who will need to take makeup SOL tests from last week will be testing. Remember, testing can occur throughout the building. Please be quiet when passing through the halls and on your way to Encore, lunch, and out the door to the athletic fields. Also, please stay away from all windows when you are outside. There will be a notice when testing is complete. We have no after-school programs to report today. Now for the birthdays with Zephania. Oh, now for Word Power with Peyton.
It's now time for Word Power. Our Word Power word for this week is gullible. Gullible means easily tricked because of being too trusting. This week, try to use this word in your classrooms and throughout the school. This Thursday, two sentences will be chosen and the winners will be able to read their sentence on Friday's MacTV program. Ask your teacher for a form or just write your name and teacher on a plain piece of paper along with your sentence. And remember to submit it to Room 5 by Thursday to be entered for Friday. Now for the birthdays with Zephania.
We have the following birthdays to report today. Happy birthday to Derek in Ms. Harris's class, Emily in Ms. Bousquet's class, and Teague in Ms. Turch's class. Happy birthday, Derek, Emily, Teague. We hope you have a great day. Now for the interview with our special guest to lead us with the Pledge of Allegiance.
Madison from Ms. Campbell's class here today with our special guest, General Colleton. Thank you for being with us today, General Colleton. Can you tell us what a typical day is like being in the General Army? That is, if there is a typical day.
Thanks, Madison. Well, I would say there's no typical day. You never know what's going to happen and you just got to adapt. So if I could have a typical day, what I like to do is start with a cup of coffee. I usually get up about 5 or 6 o'clock in the morning, have my coffee, read the news, scan through my work emails and see what's going on across the world. And then what I really like to do is then go for a run and do some PT. We like to call it physical training.
That's really cool. How do you know what you wanted to serve our country by being in the Army?
So I wasn't sure exactly what I wanted to do when I was growing up, but I like to build and I like to draw pictures of buildings. But I also saw pictures of my grandfather in World War II. I saw a picture of my dad in Vietnam. He was in the Navy, and I saw pictures of my uncles that were also in the Army and the Marines. And so when I was applying to college, I needed to find a scholarship to help pay for school, and I applied for an ROTC scholarship, and that helped me pay for college where I studied architecture.
Cool. What do you like most about your job?
So what I like most, and I mentioned this, I like building things, so I'm an engineer. So I get to build buildings, and some of the things we get to do, I built buildings like hospitals for soldiers and their families. We get to build dams and levees that provide flood protection to protect people's homes and property and lives. And we also get to improve the environment by improving water quality and planting native trees and species to allow healthy, happy ecosystems.
It's a very nice thing to do.
Thank you.
What is the most interesting or funniest thing that has happened to you in your job?
Well, it's not funny, but I would say it's really interesting for me, and maybe you guys will get to do this one day. So what I learned to do when I was a lieutenant is learn how to jump out of airplanes. And so you think, who would jump out of airplanes? But I got trained on how to jump out of airplanes safely. So you know how to ensure your parachute is packed correctly, and you get trained as to what the right way to do, who to take commands from, and how to jump out of an airplane so that you can land in sort of an unknown spot. And we get awarded different kinds of airborne wings, like I wear on my shirt. And so this one with the star on it means that I know enough where I actually can lead a command to send people out of an airplane safely. So suppose we have to go somewhere on an island or in a remote location, and you can't drive there by car or truck or bus, we can send soldiers in by airplane. So we can fly over the island and land soldiers in there, and they can come from the air.
What's your favorite book?
So there's this small little book that I like. It's called A Message to Garcia by Elbert Hubbard. And it tells the story of a new officer, a very young officer, who in the Spanish-American War was given an order by President McKinley to deliver this message to General Garcia, who was the general of the Cuban insurgents. And so what you learn about it is the young officer took the message, and he didn't ask, why do I have to deliver this? Where do I need to go? How do I get there? Are you sure you want me to deliver this? He didn't question it. He just took the initiative and found a way to make that mission happen, and he did. And that actually helped the war.
Can you tell us about Memorial Day? Why do we celebrate it?
I sure can. So Memorial Day is coming up. It's the last Monday in May, so next Monday. And so Memorial Day is a day that we celebrate, or we remember those members of the armed forces that have fallen in battle or fallen while serving in the armed forces. So the Army, the Air Force, the Marines, the Coast Guard. And so it's different than Veterans Day. So there's many that have served, whether it's 1 year, 2 years, or a career, but are still living or have been a veteran. But Memorial Day is specifically for those members of the armed forces that have died while serving. And it actually started after the Civil War. We lost many soldiers that fought on both sides, the Union and the Confederate side. And so to honor those soldiers at Arlington Cemetery, which was the first celebration, they called it Decoration Day. And people came in and they decorated the gravestones of those soldiers. And later on, after we had a few other wars, not just the Civil War, but World War I and other wars, we decided we would celebrate the memory of all those soldiers that have fallen. And so since then, it's been called Memorial Day.
Now, we'd like to ask you to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Would everyone please stand?
It would be my honor. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated.
It is now time for the moment of silence.